Dutta, and today we are going to discuss about reciprocating pump test rig trainer, and its order code is 23246610.3. So in this video we are going to discuss the components and the working of this trainer.
So this is the reciprocating pump test rig trainer. So here we are having, this is our control panel. So here RPM meter is there, then energy meter is there, then this is the 4 pole MCB, and this LED indicator will be shown when there is main supply provided, and here we will use 3 phase supply. So this is the 3 phase induction motor, and here we are having the pulley system for 3 different speeds, and this is the suction pump or centrifugal pump, and this is the suction line. Here we are having pressure gauge for measuring the pressure in the suction line, and this is the sump tank, this is the measuring tank, and this is the discharge line. On the discharge line also we are having control valve, and this is the pressure gauge for measuring the pressure in the discharge line. Then this is the valve for discharge of the sump tank, and this is the proximity sensor, and this is the discharge of the measuring tank. So here you can see there are 3 speeds for the pulley, so you can shift the belt to 3 ranges, and you can control the speed by using this. On the back side of the control panel, here you will find a socket. Here we have to connect the centrifugal pump socket, and the main control panel will be connected to the 3 phase supply. So now we will see the working of this reciprocating pump test trainer. So firstly we have to fill this sump tank with water up to 3/4 of its capacity, and then we have to ensure the drainage valve of the sump tank should be closed. So here you can see that it is closed right now. So after closing the drainage valve of the sump tank, we have to fill the water inside the sump tank up to 3/4 of its capacity, and then we have to ensure the valve position of suction line. So we have to partially open the valve of the suction line and the discharge line also. So here you will see, this is the control valve of the discharge line, so we have to partially open this. So you have to partially open it. And this also you have to partially open it. Then here you can see, this is the pressure gauge where the pressure will be indicated. So you have to take the readings from this pressure gauge for the suction line. And for the discharge line, we have to take the reading from this pressure gauge. And we have to keep its valve position like this. So we have to keep this valve position on. So it is off, and this is the on position. So we have to keep it on. So this is the control unit. So we have to connect the control unit through the main 3-phase supply, and we have to connect the plug of the 3-phase induction motor to this control unit backside. So on the backside of this control unit, there is a socket. So we have to connect the 3-phase induction motor directly to the control unit, and we have to connect the control unit to the main 3-phase supply. And now we will provide the supply to the control unit. So here you can see the RPM meter is on, and the energy meter is also on, and this LED indicator is indicating that we are getting the supply, and currently the MCB is off. So while doing the experiment, we have to keep the 4 pole MCB at on position. Now we will switch on the control panel and perform the experiment, but before that we have to keep this flow pipe position here in the measuring tank, and we can measure the volume from this scale, and we have to take the readings at a fixed time interval, like 5 seconds, 10 seconds interval, and we can record the volume of the water that is stored in the measuring cylinder. And from here we have to take the reading of the vacuum, and here we have to take the reading from
pressure gauge. So this discharge line will give the pressure reading and the suction line give the vacuum reading. So from these two meters we have to take the readings at a particular time interval, and we have to take the readings and fill in the observation table that is provided in the manual. Now we will switch on the control panel. So here you can see this is the RPM reading we are getting from this proximity sensor. So this is the proximity sensor, this is giving the RPM reading, and we can take the RPM reading from the control panel. So from here we can take the RPM reading, and these are the energy meter reading for three phase. And here you can see the flow of water. So the water is currently flowing back in the sump tank, so we have to rotate that flow pipe in the measuring tank so that the measuring tank will fill. We have to keep the drainage of the measuring tank closed so that the water did not go back in the sump tank. So we have to keep the drainage valve of the measuring tank closed so that the water gets stored in the measuring tank, and we can take the readings from this scale level indicator. So now we will fill the water in the measuring tank for 5 seconds. So here you can see now the water gets filled in the measuring tank, and you can take the reading from the level indicator. So here you can see that this is the level indicator reading we are getting. So after 5 to 10 seconds you have to after taking the reading you have to keep this flow pipe back to its position where the water goes directly inside the sump tank. So by taking reading you have to keep it like this, and after that you have to keep this back. So from here you can take the vacuum reading of the suction line. So here we are getting the vacuum reading. You can control it by using this control valve. So by using this control valve you can control the vacuum reading. And here also you can see, you can take the pressure reading from this. You have to keep the valve position like this, and you can take the pressure reading. You can control the pressure by using this control valve. So that is how you can take the readings. So after taking the reading of RPM and the vacuum gauge and the pressure gauge, you have to take the observations and you have to do the calculations by using this data that is provided in the manual. So here you will see area of measuring tank and diameter of cylinder, then diameter of cylinder D, then efficiency of transmission. So all the data is provided in the manual. So you have to do the calculations likewise. So here you can see, this is the observation table in which we have to take the readings. So the first one is the RPM reading, then PD is the kg per centimeter square, that is the pressure in the pressure gauge, and this is PS, we have to take this reading from the vacuum gauge, and R1 reading, we have to take R1 and R2 readings from the measuring tank level indicator. So on the scale of the this level indicator reading, we have to take the readings of R1 and R2, and we have to fill the data here. Then this is the time and this is the power. And in the manual also calculations are given and all the parameters are explained in the manual. So here you will see all the things are defined in the table. So that is how you can perform this experiment and take the readings. So you can also adjust the speed of the pump by shifting the pulley belt. So you have to loose these screws so that the belt will be loosened, and you have to shift the pulley belt on the three sections that I provided on the motor also, and on the bottom you will also find the three different sizes. So here you can shift the pulley belt and you can adjust the speed of the pump. So here you can see that after losing the screw of this pump, you can lose the pulley belt and you can shift it to any of the three sizes for adjusting the speed of this pump. So that's all the demonstration from my side. If you have any query related to this trainer, you can contact the Tesca Global website. You can find the link in the description. For more information, go through the manual. Thank you for watching this video. If you like this video, like, share and subscribe to our channel.